been a while since we've been back, but as we were just driving in this morning, just recognizing all the different surroundings and different ponds and cornfields and places, you know, things like that, brought back a lot of good memories. And good memories here too, with MYF and Quiz, which Chicks still is the best quiz name ever for a team. I hope that still stands. And then Sardines in the Basement, and it just, you know, the memories just kept flooding back. So I appreciate the leadership and inviting us in this morning, being able to share a little bit about what God has placed on our hearts and what we want to do in the city of Detroit.
So I'm Kristen, Aaron's wife, and it's so nice to be here, exactly like you said. We want to tell you a little bit about Haven, but first I want to kind of help you all understand where the journey started, because it is a long time coming. And one of the things about our presentation today is it's a little bit more about what is Haven and kind of who are we. But the thing that I hope you all hear through the whole time is that there really is so much, there's a story, there's a thread of like God's faithfulness through the whole thing. And that kind of, as Aaron and I have had examples and modeled to us how to be faithful to God's calling in our life, the more we've stepped out in faith, the more we've seen God work. And so even though we're here telling you about Haven kind of as an organization, we hope that you see that it's a bigger part of God's story of faithfulness to our family and hopefully to the people around us. So Haven Homes actually started from a dream back in 2014. The church that we go to up in Michigan does a Love Runs. It's a running ministry, and we raise money by running marathons and half marathons and 5Ks, and the money goes to local agencies that are working with victims of human trafficking. So through Love Runs, our family has raised about $35,000. We've all run multiple races. I've done a couple four marathons, four half marathons, and the 5K is next Saturday.
I only run the 5K.
But the need and the cause really opened our eyes to the issue that human trafficking is in Detroit, for specifically in the Detroit area. And it was during the first year I had never run and decided that I was called to run the marathon. I just prayed really hard about why was I doing this and what was the purpose, and God telling me that He had more for us and that I would know when the time is right. It wasn't then, but that He was preparing us to be in Detroit taking care of women. That dream kind of lived in our hearts for almost 5 years. Because of Love Runs, actually Aaron started doing outreach with a street mission group. It's called All Worthy of Love. And they go out and pray and give food and hygiene kits to women who are kind of in areas that they know have a lot of human trafficking. And Aaron had known about my dream to be in Detroit, but we were just waiting for the right time. And I'll never forget one night he came home, and a woman that they had taken off of the street, she went to go to rehab, had been in rehab, left rehab and actually ended up back in the same spot where she was being trafficked and really had a very horrible outcome and was a tragedy. And Aaron came home and said he understood why housing was important. He understood why God had given me the vision that He did, and that Aaron believed we were supposed to be in Detroit as well. So that was in 2019, and then by 2020 we had named our organization Haven Homes of Detroit and had started to figure out what this would look like. So our mission, our values, we are a community. I think one of the things that we talk about, Aaron and I, is this idea that community is really important. We both grew up in the Mennonite church and believe that there's a lot of healing and love, and that really is what transforms lives. And so it's creating a community of safe housing for women that have either left human trafficking or commercial sexual exploitation. And our mission is to create a safe housing for these women to give them space to heal. One of the things that we know is when your basic needs aren't met, it's hard to work on trauma. It's hard to work on getting better in therapy and getting health care and all of these other things, vocational training, that all of us take for granted and really are important for women to be able to move on in their life. So why do we exist? We exist to provide safe housing. We have transitional housing is what it's called. So women come to Haven after they've been leaving rehab, or if they've been on the streets but don't have secure housing, they can come to us for 18 to 24 months. We have women, other staff that work at the house to help set up appointments, to give medical care, make sure they have IDs, other things like that, basic health care and other needs. And by providing that support around them, it really helps women during this time be able to to focus on themselves and the healing they need to do. And really, all of this comes from, I think, Aaron, my faith background. That, like, God has given us all a name. We are all worthy of Him. We are worth caring about and taking care of because Jesus died on the cross for us all. One of the things that I want to say as far as faith is that when Aaron and I look back, we kind of sometimes it feels like that, a kind of a twisted path. I'm a nurse practitioner, I'm in pharmaceutical sales now. Aaron has been in social work jobs, he's done construction, he's done strength and conditioning coaching, all of these things. And sometimes it would be frustrating for us to see, where is this all going? Why are we here? And kind of why is God calling us on this path? But really, when we realize what a problem housing is and providing health care, Aaron's background of construction, my background as being a nurse practitioner, really kind of felt like God was calling and using those skills that He's developed in us. And so we have been called to this idea of housing as a main part of the problem. Women leaving human trafficking, housing is one of the most reported needs they have. And it really, because of the lack of stable housing, is the reason that a lot of women end up in this risky situation in general. And so we really feel like this is how we've been equipped to help address the issue, by taking away the insecurity of knowing where they're going to sleep, that they have a safe neighborhood and a community of people rooting for them. We believe that we can make a difference by providing safe housing.
So just to dive a little bit deeper into, you know, what we do now, now that Kristen's explained, you know, why we're doing it. So like, as Kristen mentioned, so I'm a licensed builder. When I left Eastern in 2019, I went back and decided to flip homes, which seems random, but 4 years later, it kind of all makes sense. So really, our mission is twofold. One, to be able to renovate the home in Detroit that, in their heyday, were beautiful manufactured homes, and you cannot find construction like that now. So our first mission is to renovate those homes, to be able to provide a safe, secure, consistent housing situation for women. The second thing is to remove one of the barriers for women leaving human trafficking, which is largely financial. Having to pay for children and health care and housing itself. So when they come to us, they're in our program for 18 to 24 months. That 18 to 24 months is rent-free. So we pay everything. The house is paid off, the first one we renovated. They come in, we pay all utilities, we pay a certain amount of dollars towards nutrition every month. We pay for additional health care and dental and things like that, as well as transportation to and from appointments. So really our goal was to remove all the barriers, which will allow them to actually focus on themselves and start that healing process. Additionally, we surrounded ourselves with a lot of resources. The reason we chose Detroit was because of the number of resources within Detroit, in terms of service providers from mental health, sobriety support, vocational assessment and assistance, as well as life skills building and
legal services,
which is an important piece. We didn't want to reinvent the wheel. We are not the only transitional home in Detroit, but we are one of two currently, and there are a number in the surrounding area. But the problem is so large, we cannot renovate homes fast enough to be able to offset the problem. So what we did, as Kristen mentioned, in 2021, we officially became a 501c3. And, you know, similar to, you know, building a house together, starting an organization can be equally as challenging but joyful at the same time. And so in 2021, we started Haven Homes in Detroit, and we wanted to surround ourselves with a like-minded individuals that had a similar vision as to what we did to be able to move forward with this, this mission. So we have changed some things throughout the couple of years we've been in existence, but we feel like we have a really good board of directors in place, as well as the support team that works directly with me. So I felt, as the executive director, it was going to be important to surround myself with people that had a similar vision, would be able to cast that vision. To cast that vision and really expand our vision to a larger community just beyond the one that we currently exist in. So with that, everything has been completely God's timing. I try to control things a little bit too much, and it never worked out. And so this is, you know, a growth opportunity for for me to be able to sit back and let God work and let me see his vision for where he wants to take Haven. And the people that are on my advisory board have just fallen into place at the time that we've needed them from, you know, Emily Johnson, who is our current, or our new program director, to Beth, who runs our day-to-day operation, and Alice, who actually is a survivor, and is our lead residential specialist. But the timing of meeting those people lined up with where they were in their journey. And so it was neat to see, you know, how God had a hand in everything. So as Kristen mentioned, we want to build community, but we also know that it takes a village to be able to heal. And so, again, a number of resources in Detroit that have been doing that a lot longer than what we have, we wanted to be able to lean on them. And so we've reached out to a lot of them, from mental health support, sobriety support with AA and NA meetings, Detroit Works with vocational training, and Avalon and Team Wellness, being able to build relationships with them to provide our residents the services that they need to heal, and that they, quite honestly, deserve.
I think one of the things for when we think about all the people around us is Aaron and I have been really thoughtful and keep trying to pray and use our board to help us make sure that we are doing what God's called us to do and that we're networking and using other people who have expertise in other areas. We don't know all of this, and really we have been so thankful and grateful to see kind of all the different agencies and people that have reached out and wanted to help us as we take care of women at our house. It's been super cool to see. And some of these slides, for you all seeing them for the first time, it's hard to explain even the slide before with all the people on it. Like Aaron said, they're all God's stories how they got there. All of this is amazing to see that we actually have enough to put together in a presentation and talk about. But we really have been so blessed by all the people coming alongside of us to help us and take care of the women at Haven Home.
So just to give you an idea of where we've come since 2021, we looked at a lot of different homes.
And home shopping in Detroit is very different than what we had done before. It was an interesting experience.
But then finally chose the one that we felt like really would serve us well and the women that we wanted to provide services to. So we were able to, through my flipping business, and just a brief story on that, I started my flipping business in 2019, and in the middle of the night, clear as day, something just spoke to me, and it said, and I just heard it Thursday, like, you're not going to make any money flipping homes. And I was like, okay, maybe it's the market we're in, whatever, interest rates. That wasn't the case. So I've been able to do 11 homes since 2019 now, and 20-30% of the profits that I receive on that goes directly towards Haven Homes. And that's what kind of got us started, and raising enough money to purchase our first home, which was $40,000. But we knew that it needed a lot of renovation, and we'll get to those photos in a second here. But we were able to raise $150,000 in our first year to be able to put that down payment down, purchase it outright, and then continue the renovations. It's all about relationships. And so through my business, I've been able to build relationships with subcontractors. And once I cast this vision to them, they were on board with wanting to come in and do any kind of donations or be able to provide some volunteer work. As we fast forward, like we said, the timing of our staff falling into place is nothing short of a miracle. It's just been amazing to see it unfold and to get to the point where we are now and be just over 90 days in from having opened our doors. But, like I said, we know that one house is not going to do it. So currently, we can have four women in our first house. We're about to intake our third person on Monday, which is amazing. And we have a purchase agreement in place for our second home, which happens to be directly across the street, which will allow us to expand for three more beds, as well as be able to have the first floor be an office space. And it might seem odd, but we're also going to have a podcast room. Our lead survivor wants to be able to do podcasts with other survivors to get the message out, to be able to tell their stories, to be able to provide hope to people in their healing process. So that is our first home. That 1912 house has amazing bones. I would talk to my subcontractors, and they would walk in and be like, you really have some vision to be able to see an end result here. Just over a year, we purchased in November 2021, and by December 2022, we had final approval on all our inspections. So just a brief snippet. Pictures are great, but if this doesn't get you, I don't know what will. This is one of the first times Kristen walked through when we shot this video, just helping us understand, like, this is a home for women. And we really want it to be a home. We want it to be a community for the women so they can continue their process. So.
And I think, like Aaron said real quick, was that we picked the house. It was very strategic. It's near a bus route. We're in a great neighborhood as far as a lot of neighborhood support. But there was something when I walked into the house, and I didn't know Aaron was taking this video, the very first time or one of the first times that we did it, and I knew at that moment that this was the house God had called for us. Thank you.
You just before you know. You know what it's like to be tied, lonely in the shadow of your own soul. You start to worry. You don't know what it takes.
All the help and support and Aaron's hard work, lots of hours, we ended up with this for our after. And this is currently the home. We have, like Aaron said, two women living in there, more moving in. We can hold up to four, and they love this house and take such good care of it. It is amazing to see it all the time and remember where we started. Again, a big piece of kind of the faith story is knowing that Aaron and I, as two people with three kids and full-time jobs, how in the world we are going to take care of kind of this vision and shepherd this vision that God has given us. And truly, it has been through volunteers and people that have believed in us and the mission that we're providing. We have had almost 800 hours of volunteer time given to Haven. You can see Aaron has some people over. They helped us paint. We have done multiple cleanup days. And then the last one on the right there is Home Depot came out. One of our board members is at Home Depot, and they cleaned up our yard in record time. I cannot believe it. And we're so thankful and just really realize the value of people catching our mission and being able to help us. Aaron had mentioned also we have had so many different businesses come along to see what we're doing and offer to help. Humble Designs, that one up in the right, they are the coolest organization. They started in Detroit, are all over now. Oops. It means this will be done. I'm sorry. Our time is up. I was going to say, Humble Design still catches the mission and vision of providing safe housing, and they came in, they decorate the house for people, homeless or people facing housing insecurity in Detroit, and they came in, gave us all of the furniture, all of, they supplied our kitchen cabinets, they took care of rugs, furniture, all of it, and we have just had multiple stories like that. Breakworks is a solo faith story. The guy that was supposed to be doing our front porch, he totally just dropped off the face of the earth. Aaron put it out there on a whim that we needed somebody, and Brickworks responded. And they actually, their whole organization, their CEO and down, are people that are in recovery. They gave us amazing front porch beyond what we could have imagined, and have since then remained engaged. They believe in sobriety support. It's so cool. So again, this picture just does not even show or express the ways of God's faithfulness through this. And this is a quote that Aaron had from AWOL, which is actually the outreach mission that he does. And I think it's from a woman that they met, and she just said, I wanted to make sure you were coming tonight. I needed prayer. I see that car, and my life just feels full. The food is nice, but it's the love, acceptance, and genuine care that makes me feel so valuable. And Aaron and I just feel really blessed to be a part of not only other organizations like Love Runs and AWOL that gave us this vision, but this is really what we're hoping to give with Haven Homes of Detroit as we move forward now.
We just want to thank you for the opportunity to be able to present to you guys this morning. We will be around through the Sunday school hours to be able to answer more questions if you have them, or just chat and catch up. That's fine as well. But we are just beyond blessed. We feel God has truly brought us to this point and continues to lead us daily. It's not without struggle and some roadblocks along the way, but we truly believe that we are putting women in a better position.